working to end the cycle of gun violence and help victims' families cope after tragedy.
Yeah, new program just launched, and it focuses on using the power of human connection to make a difference. WVTM 13's Ian Wright shows us how it works in tonight's Project Community.
Thank you for doing patiently await for our arrival.
Volunteers with the Peacemakers spend most Monday evenings here. They visit with neighbors and talk about concerns in an effort to keep these neighborhoods safe. And now these volunteers are expanding their outreach and fellowship.
This isn't about us being individuals.
Onayemi Williams with Faith in Action Alabama tells me this latest mission came about after visiting with more than 100 families impacted by homicides last year. Those families' concerns, their questions, and their needs were the catalyst for the Victims Response Program.
Just being able to develop a network that allows individuals to be able to get resources and help move them through this process is huge. And being able to put them in community and let them know that their community really, really loves them and they're not alone.
These men and women training tonight will be the voice a person hears on the phone when they have a question or need to talk to someone, or the person who greets them in their hour of need.
Once they received that information, they were just lost. They didn't know what to do next. They didn't know where to turn. They didn't know what services were available, and they were kind of left to their own demise to figure it out.
Now all of that information is inside these packets. It includes crisis hotline numbers, grief group or counseling contacts, and an application for the Alabama Crime Victims Compensation that provides money to help with things like funeral costs or counseling. The Peacemakers campaign, along with Faith in Action, put the packets together and gave them to police, who can now share them with victims' families. But there's another piece to this program. Williams says about a third of homicides here in Birmingham are retaliatory. This is about stopping that cycle of violence, connecting with victims' families, and helping them work through their grief so they don't do something they'll regret.
How do you not lash out when you're carrying so much? Being able to have people around you encircle you in love helps you carry that weight, and you're not carrying it alone. And maybe keep you from doing something rash just out of your grief.
Helping others work toward healing in hopes of ultimately ending violence in our communities.
It's just another tool in the toolbox. It's just another way to show people that you are loved, you do matter. And if you are lost in this cycle, that we're trying to do everything we can to find ways for you to get out of that cycle.
40 people have already signed up to help, and they need more volunteers. And there are a number of ways that you can get involved. You can host a grief group. You can even answer phone calls. Coming up here in less than 2 hours at 7 o'clock, we're going to talk live with members of the volunteer team about ways that you can help and more about what this program does in our community. So join us at 7 o'clock for a Facebook Live conversation on the WVTM 13 Facebook page.